running with the set, yeah. Running with the set, yeah. Yeah. We don't never flex, we just rip. Hear me? No. What did you expect? I don't need respect, I'm the threat. Tell them I'm so free, I got no chains on me. I'm so free, I got no chains on me. Nappy hair, no shame on me. I'm so free, I got no chains on me. I'm so free, I got no chains on me. I'm so free, I got no chains on me. I'm so free, I got no chains on me. I'm so free, I got chip running through the. Just give up Insta snaps. Do we need another post? You insecure, you do the most.
On my side, we revive God through the Wi-Fi. T'Challa pop the never colonized. Round the high fives for the top God made us dangerous. Aim to bust flame, but dust. Every act to bring to us. Gangs of us trained to trust a name that's blood stained on us. Christ gained on us.
I was running with the same, yeah. Running through a chain, yeah, yeah. No chains on me. I'm so free, I got no chains on me. Nappy hair, no shame on me. I'm so free, I got no chains on me.
I'm so free, I got no chains. Look at my neck, no chains. No chains. Rapper.
Yeah, come get your opinion, they don't matter. Money or the faith, I chose a lot of. Ooh, I can see I'm trying to keep us on the outside now. We pull up and watch you scatter back. Running through the wall. Heaven got a playlist. I promise that's my favorite placement.
Faithful love of fame. Hey peeps, how y'all doing today? You're doing good. That's good. Me? How I'm doing? I'm doing good. Feel good, y'all. Feel good. I feel good. Like I know that I would. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Like the hubby said, take me to mess up a song. I like beats. I like music. I don't like really singing them. I do my best. But yeah, y'all, today is February the 25th, Monday, the beginning of a new week at 1:32 in the p.m. We just finished up homeschooling about a half an hour ago, but I had to get my life together. Yeah, so my hair got washed, finally. Rain washed it. Shein, like, put it in. I wanted six braids on this side and six braids on this side. And I'm just wearing like this for a minute, y'all, because what else? But let me see. Recap. What I've been doing. Saturday. So what happened Saturday? Been chilling. Really, I just been chilling, y'all. It was Shan with the cook, but we had Taco Bell Saturday. Yesterday, I'm not really doing nothing. I think I got my kids' work together Saturday. I think I was doing that mostly all Saturday, doing a lot of paperwork. So yesterday, I could just chill. And today, start my week to clean up the kitchen. I started already. I went in there and just wipe a lot of my stuff down because they just don't have no love for my kitchen, y'all. So I had to go get my kitchen some love. I had to get my can opener some love. I had to clean that can open. Like they don't love you, can opener. They got all this stuff splattered all over you. Where's the love for the can opener? So, yeah, I'm like, y'all just don't love my kitchen, man. But I went in there and I handled that. I took care of the kitchen. I showed the kitchen all kind of love, the microwave, the refrigerator. I washed off all my bottles because I have my bottles kind of like in this rack on my wall with vinegar, Pansol, Fabuloso. I think I got the apple cider vinegar method. Is it method? And one of them, dishwash. I got them two glass bottles, one with dishwashing liquid in it and one with the liquid foam soap. I had to wash off all that. They don't be showing my kitchen no love. Them 2 weeks that I don't be in my kitchen like that, they be up in there abusing my kitchen. So yeah, I went in there, swept, vacuumed, behind the garbage, behind the mop bucket. I just got her done. So it won't be so much for me to do when I actually have to wash dishes when we finish dinner. I was gonna clean the stove, but I'm like, she probably used that. It's rent a week to cook. So she making spaghetti and something. I'm not eating now. I'm gonna eat something else. Cause I'm kinda over pasta. I don't really care for pasta like I used to. I might eat a little spaghetti, but not like that. So yeah, I ain't really been doing nothing this weekend, y'all. Just chilling. I got my hair it is. Oh yeah, I got my hair did last night. So we was watching Blind Spot while Shein was braiding on my hair. So that's what happened. But y'all, guess I don't cost y'all up. And we're gonna get ready to do this reading, get her done, cause y'all know how our Mondays are. And yeah, guess that's about it, cause I can't. Oh, let me show y'all what I'm snacking on. Wait for it. It's a big old bag, y'all. 16 ounce, 1 pound bag. Snack situation be real up in here. So yeah, I had a bag clip because I had one on my other potato chips I had bought, but I put it back. I always keep these in my drawer, so they work just as fine. Oh, but as far as my health and everything, I haven't been coughing. I mean, I might have spurts when my throat get really, really dry, but other than that, I'm good. I think I'm not going to say I'm 100% because I don't feel 100, but I think I'm like 99.9. So yeah, besides being sluggish because today Monday, but other than that, I'm good. So and then I got like a crook in my neck. I got like all up in here because the way I be holding the phone talking to the hubby, I think I stayed in that position too long, so I'm happy. So I guess that's about it. There's no veggie straws. All right, they be having me choking. Oh no, I think all and it's that ranch powder seasoning on it. I think it that's me doing it. I really don't eat ranch like that, but I can. They had the sea salt can, but I already had some other kind of chips with the salt in it. So I did the ranch in these. But yeah, y'all, that's enough chit chat. Let's get our read on. Look, y'all trying to prolong this read. Y'all know after coming from a weekend, we be mean our spiritual manifest. Simple as that. And I'm here to get her done. I'm here to get her done, y'all. So, let's get her done. I had showed y'all my clips. I had bought a lot of these. Well, I got bought a lot of the stuff to deal with my cords, to try to contain my cord situation. So yeah, these is really good. I like these little things, y'all. Yeah. I just went on Amazon looking for stuff. Cause I got I got some of these up under my up under my behind my desk. See, they Velcro, they stick. And you can just wrap around little cords like I did the one. My keyboard cord is long. And it's like it has to hook into my back of my in the USB port back there. So it be in my way. You know, I be cleaning my desk and stuff. So I just rolled it up and wrapped one of these around in there. They come in handy. They really do. Be things that be trying to annoy my nerves. I'm like, I got you. Like a fly. I'm going to get a fly swatter. Or I'm going to get some raid. But you're going to get gat. Because flies are very annoying. And I have like the worst case of them when it's the summer. Because that garbage on that back. Yup, I just went there. They be all around my garbage. Oh my God. But I had looked up some like DIY ways to get rid of flies and made like a concoction. I think it kind of sort of worked toward the end. I don't know if it worked or they was moving on, but I was starting not to see the flies around my garbage as much as when I put some. I think they was like different type of essential oils. I kind of like put it all around my garbage can top and stuff. But yeah, I got these for those. The annoying situation with cords, basically. All right, I'm done. I ain't talked to y'all since Friday, okay? It been a minute. So y'all, I'm still in chapter 3. Topic is called led to hear God's prompting of your spirit. Amen. I just love that topic title. I never thought about it that way, the prompting of the Holy Spirit. And then I was talking to the hubby like this morning. I had the nurse. I'm like, yeah, because you know the Holy Spirit would be prompting. I'm like, oh, look at me. Okay, bring it on in my vocabulary. When I said it, I was like, I just used that word. Just a basic conversation. Oh my gosh. I bet the husband was like, She must have read that word in her book. Oh my goodness gracious. Okay, here we go. Y'all ready? Let's get her done. I went to a physical therapist for my back a few days before my son's wedding. On my way home, I had a prompting. There you go. I should stop by a certain business to make sure that something very important I needed to pick up for the wedding will be ready on time. I definitely did not want to take the time to stop. Because I was already late for a dinner party, it had been a busy day. It was going to be inconvenient to stop. I felt quite tired, and also it was painful getting in and out of the car. But I knew I should not ignore the prompting in my spirit that said I should stop to see if everything was on schedule. Because it was hurting her to get in and out of the car because she had just went to a physical therapist for her back. Oh, the back problems. Oh my gosh. Like, why do the back got to hurt like that? I had specifically prayed that day and every day for all the wedding details. That's why I thought it must be the Holy Spirit guiding me. If it had been left up to me, It's Monday, y'all. That's all. I'm gonna blame all. Every time I mess up a word, I don't care if it ain't Monday. It still affects a Monday. It's just rolling over into the next day. Shoot. Okay, here we go. Let's redo this. If it had been left up to me, I would not have even thought to go there. So I stopped in at this place of business just as they was closing at 6 p.m. Another minute later, and they would have been gone. I was shocked to find out that they had been so swamped with business that week that what I needed for the wedding had been pushed to the back of their schedule. What? The owner had completely forgotten the date of the wedding and assumed we had a few weeks more. That assumption, man. See, assuming, man. People get hurt assuming. You assume what? Oh. But who told you that? You can't just be assuming things. You just can't let your man be going places and making up stuff. This is real life. This is not Alice. What's called? Alice in Wonderland. Boy, you can't go down the rabbit hole with my life. You can't just assume and make up stuff. It's Monday, y'all. It's Monday. Y'all just follow me. Just follow me. Follow me down the rabbit hole and back to the book. Just follow me, okay? Here we go. Okay. The owner had completely forgotten the date of the wedding and assumed we had a few weeks more, when actually there were only 2 days left. If I had not stopped right then and checked on it, what I needed would not have been done. Wow. I thank God profusely all the way home from that prompting, for that prompting. The Holy Spirit was in the details because I had invited him to be. Amen. He had prompted my heart to do something I didn't want to do. And thank God I listened. My words is just all messed up today. I think it's those veggie straws. The closer you are to God, the more you welcome the fullness of His Spirit in you. Amen. The more you will learn to identify and trust His prompting in your heart. This happened countless times to me. Amen. I could write an entire book on this subject alone. Amen. I am sure these things have happened to you as well if your heart is sensitive to the Holy Spirit. Amen. In order not to miss a prompting of your soul, battle Holy Spirit. Stay close to the Lord and walk with Him in His Word, in prayer, and in praise and worship every day. You will be glad you did. Wow, I like that. I done had a lot of promptings. I feel fancy for some reason saying our prompting, darling. Oh, it's the veggie straws. I don't be eating vegetables like that. I think I'm just like, I've been going in on the veggie straws today. Okay. But y'all, I got her done. And that was a really, really good read. And my favorite part, I like the whole part, y'all know, but in order not to miss a prompting of your soul by the Holy Spirit, stay close to the Lord and walk with Him in His Word, in prayer, and in praise and worship every day. Every day. You will be glad you did. And that's so true, because we read the Bible every other day and we pray every other day. You know, like, we pray one day. We prayed last night, so tonight we got to read the Bible. We in the book of Lord Jesus. What book we in? Is it Amos? I think it's Amos. I really think we're in the book of Amos. But, and if I'm not reading and then reading this book, I'm always listening to my music. You know, that's something that I done learned along the way that really, really, really works for me. When I used to be like being all kind of not good moves, physically and mentally and emotionally, music like spiritual music, hymns, gospel music, hymns, whatever on that type of level, music with God, about just praise and worship, it changes my mood. It's like I listen to it over and over, not the same song, but sometimes it could be a song that really hit home. I'm like, I want to hear that again, and it'll uplift me and encourage me, and it renews my strength, actually, sometimes, for real. So I listen to my music every day, and I listen to all kinds of gospel music. I listen to the old school, Shirley Caesar, and the Lee Williams brothers. I love their music. The Williams brothers, I love them. Fat Black Boys of Alabama, love them. All the way down to, it's so many, Vicky Winans, Ty Tribbett, Kirk Franklin, Hezekiah Walker, Donnie McClurk, and Yolanda Adams. I just love those type of music. And down to Lecrae is like one of my favorite gospel rappers. Bizzle, love his music, his messages. Man, them really works for me, because gospel rap is like your testimony just in a music form. I love it. Trip Lee, Tadashi, Pro. I think he changed his name from Pro to something else, but I haven't bought nothing of his in a minute. Thizzle. KB. Love me some KB music. Flame. Love me some Flame. These is all gospel rap artists. Love it, love it, love it. But I have a playlist with all that type of music, just all in there. And my playlist is like seven. Let's see how long my playlist is, because I'm constantly adding. It's 6.3 hours long. So I just play it when I'm washing dishes, when I'm cleaning up or cooking or whatever. When I'm sitting here at the my desk playing my Facebook games, I put my headphones in and play my playlist, and it just keep me in a good space, y'all. It keeps my heart, like, keeps joy down on the inside. When something trying, like, if something come my way trying to dictate my mood, look, because I'm human, I have to go there. I'm like, I need some music. I just to calm my nerves. And I know by the time I finish listening to whatever, I'm back in that place I need to be. You know what I'm saying? So I love praise and worship. I love reading the Bible. All that. I need all that, y'all. Y'all, ugh, people, life. I need that to keep me sane, to keep me focused. That's to keep me, just basically keep me focused, for real, at the end of the day. That's what it is, you know, on what matters and what don't, you know. Don't trip over that, Sharon. Let that go, Sharon. You know what I'm saying? That's what reading the Bible, reading books and stuff, and I have to do it on a daily. Just like washing my face, brushing my teeth, eating. I have to feed myself some type of spiritual food on a daily. I done been in a place where I done been malnourished. That's not a good place for me. I don't like being malnourished on a natural or in the spiritual. You get what I'm saying? So, yeah, I done learned how to feed myself a balanced course meal. Natural and spiritual. So, yeah. She said she could write a whole book about those type of tasks. My book coming, y'all. It's coming. Watch what I tell you. So, y'all, that's about it. It's 1:54 in the p.m. Let me get ready to do what I do. Y'all saw that weather. It's last night. Was it last night? It was below zero. Like, why? I'm not really asking y'all why. I'm really like, why, Heavenly Father? What? Why do we need those type of temperatures? And even, the numbers is there, but the feeling of the cold is really there. Like, I don't even know if the numbers really describing the feel of the cold. Because I don't even know if you can put numbers to that. It's like a zillion trillion below zero. It's the veggie straws. But on that note, y'all, I hope everybody have a blessed Monday, a safe Monday, a productive Monday. Get her done. And a protective Monday / Tuesday. And I'll see y'all again at my desk or the table. I'm gonna go to the table next time. Wednesday with some more read or whatever else my day may bring. February is almost out of here. Our Black History Month is almost done. So I want to find another paper to read. I just love it, y'all. I love to read stuff that just like feeds me. You know what I'm saying? Whew. So on that note, I'm out. Peace. Love, share something. What? I'll bye, y'all. See you Wednesday with some more reads and whatever else my day may bring.
When I was 17, bye, y'all. Like every other girl, I used to have big dreams. But then I got introduced to some other things. And suddenly the church girl I was originally can't see the wrong things can call your name. I chose to answer when the spirit said walk away. Now I live with circumstances that I can't erase. I just wish I could go back now to yesterday.